concerned Frankenstein. When initial filming had finished, director Robert Gaffney felt he needed more in the final battle, but because the film was already over budget, he couldn't afford to pay the original actors for additional shooting. So he and one of the crew members put on the costumes and played the two characters for the extra footage.
It takes more than a costume and an attitude to do this work.
Well, obviously, no one ever noticed. But if you tune in next week, you'll notice that... that, as usual, someone is again interrupting me as I try to wind up the program in grand fashion, and yet... they do so. Let's head over to the door and see who exactly is doing this. And I probably should mention, every time I saw that Dr. Nadir, I kept waiting for him to start whining about the precious. Because I thought, he kind of looked like that guy. You know,
oh, my dear Spenguli, one must always be very wary of beings from another planet.
Okay.
A cautionary tale relates how two astronauts went to a distant planet and had run out of food.
Oh.
They spent 2 days searching the planet's surface for food until finally they were astonished to see what they thought was a bacon tree.
A bacon tree?
Yes, a bacon tree. They hungrily approached it, but as they drew near, aliens jumped out from either side of it and began firing lasers at them. One astronaut said to the other, alas, it wasn't a bacon tree. It was a ham bush.
Colder on that planet, maybe it could
have been 6 degrees of given bacon tree. You see
it, but never. Good night, everybody! Oh, my. I was waiting for him to say, oh, dear, what's become of me? I hope that you'll be coming back next week. Join us for what probably will not be a Frankenstein movie, but something equally as exciting. Wondering, why did that princess be the only one that survived if all the other women on Mars were... I'm putting too much thought into this. I just put more into the script. See you next time. Good night.
Happy Halloween, Sven. See you next week.